Next, I'd like to introduce you to Diego Dumani from Biomedical Engineering, who will be speaking to us tonight on lights on for doctors, off for cancer.
Many of us are familiar with ultrasound to look at babies during pregnancy. But did you know that the same technology could be used to detect and treat cancer? In fact, ultrasound is already used to study breast tumors, the most common type of cancer in women and second deadliest after lung cancer. In the US, 1 in 8 women will develop breast cancer during their lifetime. This year, 250,000 new cases are expected. More than 40,000 will die. These patients die not because of their primary tumor, but because of metastasis, which is when the cancer spreads. Thus, it is critical to detect these lesions as soon as possible. Currently, doctors do biopsies of the lymph nodes around the breast. If they find cancer cells, they will remove the branch of lymph nodes to prevent the spread. However, this is an invasive procedure. It is painful, and it could even block the lymphatic system. Moreover, doctors can often miss microscopic lesions, failing to detect early metastasis. Unfortunately, ultrasound alone cannot replace this approach, but this is where my research comes in. I'm working on a non-invasive method to not only diagnose but treat metastatic lesions as soon as they're detected using a technology called photoacoustic imaging. Think of ultrasound as entering a dark room where you can bump into things but you cannot touch or see anything. Photoacoustic imaging is like turning the lights on in this room. In the body, ultrasound gives you the shape and consistency of tissue. Photoacoustic imaging gives you the color, and it does this by measuring optical absorption. What I haven't told you is that all of this can be achieved with the same ultrasound machine, just by adding a laser light source. To detect metastasis, we inject nanoparticles developed in our lab that attach to specific cancer cells. These nanoparticles have very high optical absorption, so the cells will shine on the screen. Moreover, there's more. If we add a second, more powerful laser, we can heat up these particles and burn the cancer cells, all of this while keeping the surrounding tissue intact. Now, there are challenges. We need to make sure we detect every single group of cancer cells. This is called sensitivity. At the same time, we don't want to burn healthy tissue. This is called specificity. I'm currently working on improving the sensitivity and specificity of this method in mice by trying different nanoparticles and different data processing techniques. My goal is that just like a pregnant woman can get an ultrasound of their baby, cancer patients can get effective treatment. For doctors, it would be simple. Inject, look at the screen, burn the cancer. Thank you.
Thank you, Diego. We'll give the judges a moment.